The surfboard idea started out in the Amazon, and I was taking the x-ray of the alligator for my project, and I started putting the alligators and animals and plants on surfboards. So when I got to CERN, I was looking at the chalkboards, and I thought, well, I could make a surfboard and have, you know, change it from surfboard to chalkboard and start to get the mind to expand out into the cosmos. Because I think for surfers, it's kind of a spiritual experience riding a wave. And for me, the idea of riding a wave and thinking about the cosmos was kind of a beautiful conjunction of events. What's so cool about these is that, you know, this tells the whole story of both projects from CERN, from Brazil to CERN. So I was taking, this is a python from the Amazon that was x-rayed in a hospital. So the idea was really to get these images out there and let people see the beauty and how fragile the environment is. And it's something that we want to value and prize. And I think with surfboards and skate decks, they become prized possessions. And one of my assistants is a great skater. And so this is what they look like after they've been beat up. And I like this too, because it's like the wires. All of these marks is a history. This one that does have a surfboard. You have all these crazy wires in the favela. And, you know, putting this combination of popular culture, the crazy need for resources, the beauty of the natural environment. And here, this is interesting because you have all of the wires from the favela and this geometry that you're seeing on top. These are satellite maps of Amazon land clearing. So this is actually the deforestation as seen from remote sensing, they call it. If you can even see, up top is me in the Amazon swimming with a river fish. And you know, you could see like the environment maybe being polluted by this sort of like massive black. And in the most ideal world possible, whoever would purchase this would surf this surfboard, beat it up, you know, put it back in the rack and it would blend into the painting. So the animals are being sacrificed, basically, is what's happening. And I took a high-powered rifle and I shot the center of the animal with a gun to sort of show what's going on with the sloth, because the sloth move very slowly and they have very sensitive lungs. They're very affected by the burning of the Amazon. And the reason why they're being reduced is because all of these large areas are being land cleared. So this is a satellite view of the Amazon and the land clearing. So if you're a sloth and you're stuck right here, you know, just say this is actually land clearing. Okay, you're here and you want to get to somewhere else and you got to go across an open area to get to the next area that's safe. You're very vulnerable to predators. So I wanted to get the idea, the vast sense of, you know, by making this painting so large, it was to get a sense of what the scale of it is, to really understand that these are vast areas of land that are being cleared. So I'm thinking a lot about macro and micro instances. So I'm thinking about quantum subatomic reality, as well as I'm thinking about, you know, the cosmos and a larger reality. This next thing I'm working on is really about surfing the cosmos and getting these boards on either side of a large painting. And I'm just starting the process now of laying it out. And I've actually made a couple of surfboards that are in production. They're actually galaxies. So that's the next thing coming down the pike. So I hope you come back for that one. So this is actually a representation of what happens electrically inside the body as ions move across cell membranes. And at the same time, it's a macro view of how we get the electricity to our houses to suit our needs. So it's sort of this like sandwich of human electricity. So the dialogue is always about our relationship to the environment and our relationship to each other. And right now, those relationships have become incredibly complicated. This was particularly a piece that I had fun making because when I went to the favela, there was this light bulb, and the light bulb made me think about the plants. And this particular plant is called Saco Velho, and it has a kind of a female energy inside, as you can see, and a male energy on the outside. So it's sort of like, they call it Sacco Velho because it means old sack. So it's sort of like this combination of human sexuality, the yin and yang, and then we have this idea on a larger level between the natural environment and the artificial environment based on human necessity. So this particular piece right here is sort of like the storm that we're all experiencing, right? It's sort of like the chaos and the energy surrounding, you know, where we are in the world. And in this case, you've got these crazy wires that's a representation of the drawings made by humans in order to get the things they need, and the sort of chaos and storm around it that we're all experiencing right now. Although I didn't think of it, but especially in this time of COVID. So the project that I'm working on right now is really about energy consumption and who consumes the energy. And it came out of an earlier project called Health of the Planet, where I went to Brazil and I x-rayed the Amazon. And if the Amazon are the lungs of the planet, the idea was to give the world a medical checkup. The energy use is expressed in the favela, which are the slums of Rio, by this chaotic sense of wires. And everybody in the favela has this urgent need for resources, which they're tapping at will. And what I saw when I looked at these lines everywhere in space, like the ones you see behind me, they become these human drawings in three dimension in space based on their need for resources. My representation of that is the Large Hadron Collider at CERN, which is in Geneva. So I spent time in the favela in Rio, and I spent a few weeks at the Large Hadron Collider as the theory group as a guest, and I lectured to them. So the new project is really looking at this wide range of where we all sit in this, you know, timeline and on this use line of energy. And somewhere, art sits in the middle of it. So that's my place to look at it.